So I've been through Icarus's activity file and I checked it, and double checked it, and Corey triple checked it, and it's the same results. So in other words, unless Icarus is deleting her own files, she didn't do it.
And there was no malfunction on the airlock hardware.
Which means the airlock was decoupled manually.
Cassie and I were on the flight deck the whole time.
And I was with Cap and Searle, and I think we can all assume it wasn't Harvey. Which leaves one possibility. Trey.
Trey's so doped up he can hardly walk or feed himself. He sleeps for 23 hours a day, and he blames himself for everything that's gone wrong. Why would he do it?
We don't know, but the possibility remains that it was him, and we gotta take that seriously.
By doping him up more.
This isn't just about the possibility whether he sabotaged the airlock hardware. There's something else, too. When Saul and Harvey died, we lost two breathers. If Trey dies, we'll have the oxygen to make it to the delivery point.
At least now we know what happened on Icarus 1. Same thing that's happening here.
Fuck you, Kappa. What are you trying to remind us of? Our lost humanity? I'll do it. I'm not passing any bucks.
Do it how?
That's between me and Trey. We'll have a vote this time. Unanimous decision required.
So?
You know where I stand.
And me.
What are you asking? That we weigh the life of one against the future of mankind? Kill him.
Cassie.
No.
Cassie.
I know the argument. I know the logic. You're saying you need my vote. I'm saying you can't have it.
So, what do we do?
Oh, God.
I'm sorry, Cassie.